Back from his epic escapades is the host and anchor of the show, Teddy Wilson. Welcome back, Teddy.
Hey, Ben. Good to see you, buddy. Great to see you.
Okay, let's talk about this. Season 3 takes you through Thailand, South Africa, Switzerland, Australia, Norway, Italy. Tell me your top 3 Mighty Train moments from season 3.
It's honestly very tough to whittle it down. I feel like I've got the best job on the planet. But, you know, in Switzerland this season, we take a train called the Bernina Express, and its route is one of 3 in the world that's designated as a UNESCO World Heritage Site.
The route itself?
The route itself, wow. One of 3 on Earth. And we go there in the dead of winter, so obviously the amount of snow in the Swiss Alps is just formidable. I go to South Africa this season the first time. That's our episode coming up this Sunday at 7 p.m.
Rovers
on
Rail.
Discovery. Yeah. Rovus Rail, and it's often mentioned as one of the most luxurious trains on Earth. It certainly is, but for me, I'd never been to South Africa, so pulling into Cape Town at the end of journey, seeing Table Mountain was like a life highlight for me, and those are some clips of the train you're seeing right now. It's just absolutely top-notch. And then in Australia, we take one of the longest train journeys on Earth from Perth to Sydney across from both coasts of Australia,
wow.
And we ride through an area called the Nullarbor Plain. Longest straight stretch of rail in the world, but going through the outback on a train like that was absolutely amazing.
Incredible. The season premiered with you in Thailand.
Yeah.
I don't want to give too much away, but there was some monkeying around.
There was indeed.
And what I really want to know is, did you ever get your sunglasses back?
My sunglasses?
Yes.
I actually have them on me
right now.
There
you go.
Yeah. These are not the same ones.
There we go. This is what we're talking about.
Look at that. I only ever pay $5 for sunglasses because I lose them a lot, but usually it's not monkeys that steal them. But no, that little fella got away with them.
I got to ask, as a train enthusiast, and you know, we're into season 3 now, did you ever wonder, like, if we get deeper and deeper into this show, into the seasons, are the trains going to get less mighty as we go?
Well, I actually saw, I was watching the show this morning, and I saw you ask that, you know, like, how many mighty trains can there be?
Yeah.
But we're actually currently in production on our 4th season.
Wow.
The season that's airing now on Discovery is season 3. So, you know, I just got back from Japan a day and a half ago. We were riding a train called the 7 Stars there. Before that, we were in Peru on a fantastic
7 Stars?
Train.
Is it 7 Star Service?
7 Stars. It's actually because of the region that it's in that it's named that, but it is often also called the most luxurious train on Earth. We've been in Spain and Peru recently, and so there's really no end
there's
to
no
the amount
shortage.
Of amazing trains. Yeah.
Now, I get to sit on my couch and enjoy this from the comfort of my home, but what are the challenges to shooting a show about trains, about mighty trains around the world?
Well, you know, I think from a behind-the-scenes production perspective, our crew up at EPI, the in-house production company at Discovery, they have to do a lot of pre-production and negotiation. You know, often the rail tracks are owned by the government, the trains are owned by a different company, so there's a lot of pre-production that goes into it. And then once we get in the field, we have a top-notch crew in the field, but, you know, we're often passing landmarks only once, and we have a lot of stuff that we want to talk about, so it's a lot of logistical challenges in the field. But there's certainly no shortage of amazing scenery.
Last question. We don't have a lot of time left for this one. But, you know, you've got the train itself, and then you've got the surrounding area that you're traveling through.
Yeah.
Which one is more awesome to you?
It's a really good question. You know, to me, the trains are awesome, and certainly the different types of trains we cover. Some are luxury trains, some are not at all. Some move very quickly. You know, our season finale this year, we ride the fastest train in Europe, in Italy. It's called the Frecciarossa 1000. So seeing the different types of trains is amazing, but I am also a huge travel buff.
Yeah.
I travel a lot in my personal life. So getting to see these countries and through a train window from a train is awesome. So it's a tie.
Teddy, there are very few people who are as enthusiastic about their work as you. And
Thanks, man.
That you bring us along with that enthusiasm on this show is top notch. Congratulations on season 3, my friend.
Thank you very much.
See you soon.
Appreciate it.
And Mighty Trains airs Sundays, 7 p.m. Eastern on Discovery.
Thanks for watching. If you like this, be sure to subscribe here.
And you can check out more Your Morning videos right here.